The graph of f of x equals 1 divided by x, or y equals 1 divided by x, is shown in black on this graph here. We want to match each equation with the correct graph, also graphed on the same coordinate plane. So this graph is pretty messy. The first thing we should recognize is the basic function f of x equals 1 divided by x would be the graph of this function here, graphed here in black, where one piece is in the first quadrant, and the second piece is in the third quadrant. And the first equation given is y equals 1 divided by the quantity x minus 3, which we should recognize would be equivalent to changing the input of f to x minus 3. So this is equivalent to f of the quantity x minus 3. But compare these function notations, notice how in the given function f of x, when x is 0, or the input is 0, it'll actually take larger values of x for this function to get the same inputs. Notice it takes an x value of 3 to get an input of 0 into this function. And therefore, this actually shifts the graph 3 units to the right, and therefore this equation would produce graph B. Notice graph B, this piece and this piece, is the graph of f of x shifted 3 units to the right. So this would be B. Next we have y equals 1 divided by x minus 3, which again, this would be equivalent to the function f of x minus the constant 3. Again, f of x is 1 divided by x, and we're subtracting 3. So notice for this equation, we're subtracting 3 from the function values of f of x, or the y values of f of x. Because we're subtracting 3 from the y values of f of x, this will be the graph of the basic function f of x shifted down 3 units. So going back over to our graph, notice how if we shift the black graph down 3 units in the third quadrant here, and in the first quadrant here, we have the graph of the blue function or graph C. Next we have y equals negative 1 divided by x. And again, if f of x equals 1 divided by x, this would be equivalent to negative f of x. So notice this function is changing the sign of all the function values, or the y values, of the basic function y equals 1 divided by x. So if we change the sign of all of the y coordinates, it's going to reflect the graph across the x-axis. So again, starting with the basic function highlighted here in yellow, if we reflect this across the x-axis, notice how we get the graph of the green function in the second quadrant and here in the fourth quadrant. And therefore, y equals negative 1 divided by x would give us graph D, or the green graph. And then finally, we have y equals 3 divided by x, which we could also write as 3 times 1 divided by x, which would be equivalent to 3 times f of x. So notice in this case, we would be multiplying the y values or function values of f of x by 3, and therefore this would stretch the graph vertically. So going back over to our graph, if we start with the basic function y equals 1 divided by x and stretch it vertically, it would be stretched in this direction here in the first quadrant, and this direction here in the third quadrant, which would give us the graph of the red function here and here. And therefore, y equals 3 divided by x would be the red graph, or graph A. So with practice, if we're given a basic function and then a variation of the function, we should be able to recognize the type of transformation that has occurred. I'll leave you with a quick review of the basic transformations. Here we have reflections across the x and y axis. Here we have vertical shifts up or down. Here we have horizontal shifts left. Here we have vertical stretches or vertical compressions. And finally, here we have horizontal stretches and horizontal compressions. I hope you found this helpful.